100 years ago, scattering experiments showed that there's a nucleus inside the atom, giving us the Rutherford model. In the 1930s, further scattering experiments gave us the structure of protons and neutrons inside the nucleus. In the 40s and 50s, physicists continued bashing things together with more and more energy, and something strange happened. A whole new array of new particles started to show up in the results, most of them very unstable, decaying quickly to more familiar particles like electrons and protons.
And physicists saw patterns in this strange new particle zoo. Patterns in the masses and charges and the way they decayed. It was a bit like the periodic table. The different elements in the periodic table are organised because of the structure inside atoms. Physicists wondered, do protons and neutrons and all the other weird new particles have structure inside of them too? In the early 60s, physicists Murray Gell-Mann and George Zweig predicted that some particles, including protons and neutrons, are made of three smaller fundamental particles called quarks. Other particles like pions have a quark and an antiquark inside of them.
The quark model explained many of the patterns they found in the zoo of composite particles, collectively known as hadrons. Scattering experiments in the late 70s and early 80s showed that quarks were real. Protons and neutrons do in fact have three smaller point-like particles inside them. Quarks come in different types, called flavours. Two flavours of quark, called up and down, make up almost everything around us. The proton is made of two ups and a down, while the neutron has one up and two downs. But the theoretical model of the particle zoo required more quarks for it to work, and soon physicists added the strange quark, then the charm quark, and later the very massive top and bottom quarks. That's six quarks, and that's all of them for now, though who knows what the future will bring.
Quarks are bound together through the strong nuclear force. In some ways, it's a bit like the electromagnetic force that holds atoms together. At the particle level, the electromagnetic force is an interaction with two electrically charged particles exchanging photons. The strong force is where two quarks interact by exchanging another particle called a gluon, because it glues them together. But the strong force is different to electromagnetism in really interesting ways. For starters, it's quite easy to pull an electron off an atom. Electric charges can roam free quite happily, but we never ever see a quark by itself.
We can do experiments to look deep inside a hadron to show that the force between quarks almost disappears when they're close together. But when you separate them, it gets stronger and stronger. The energy gets bigger and bigger until it's big enough to make a quark-antiquark pair. You just can't get a single quark. Quarks seem to be generally bound up in threes, in hadrons like the neutron and proton, or twos in mesons like the pion. But can they combine in other numbers? That's something physicists are working on right now. Another really interesting thing about quarks is their mass. We know an atom's mass almost entirely comes from the mass of the nucleus, with a bit from the electrons. If we add the masses of all the bits, we get pretty close to the mass of the atom. But quarks aren't like that. We know the mass of a proton. We can do experiments to work out the mass of each of the quarks inside. And it turns out that the quarks only make up around 1% of the proton's mass.
Where does the other 99% come from? You might think maybe that's the mass it gets from the Higgs. But no, that's the 1%. Again, we can do experiments to look deep inside a proton, and there's a lot going on in there. Along with the three main quarks, the so-called valence quarks, the proton is a roiling ball of gluons. And while gluons are themselves massless, like photons, they do have energy. All that energy gives the proton most of its mass. As well as the gluons, inside the proton we find what we call C quarks, loads of quark-antiquark pairs popping in and out of existence. While they're so fleeting, they do affect the proton's properties, including giving it some mass.
My research is at A2 at MAMI, which is an accelerator facility in Mainz, Germany. The main facility is MAMI, named for the Mainzer Microtron. This accelerator is unusual, because accelerators are usually a line or a loop. MAMI is a line and a rectangle, where electrons are accelerated as much as possible in a small space. Multiple recirculations of a continuous wave of electrons reach energies on the order of giga electron volts. There are currently two active halls at MAMI, A1 and A2. Despite the accelerator providing us at A2 with electrons, we use photons in our experiments. By placing an extremely thin diamond in the electron's path, some of the electron's energy is converted to photons. Using diamond means we're able to control the quantum state of the photons, a technique that is pioneering new physics. My experiment measures amongst other things, the way quarks behave when they're excited. If we change different experimental parameters, we can excite them in different ways. We can use this to build a model of how quarks behave inside hadrons and how they are impacted by changes to the hadrons themselves. We have even seen signs of quarks combining in fours. This is an extremely energetically unusual state. Could this be a dark matter candidate? We shall see.